Our guest tonight has dominated sports headlines in the past few weeks after agreeing to become the head coach of Barangay Ginebra San Miguel and winning the Commissioner's Cup with the San Mig Coffee Super Mixers. Welcome to the Solar Sports Desk, Jeffrey Cariaso.
Thank you. Thank you for joining us.
It's a pleasure finally.
To be here. Yeah, no problem.
Okay, well, when you first accepted the coaching job with Ginebra, obviously Gino and I were the first ones to text
right.
you. Please right. guest on the show. And I appreciated your response that you said just to wait until after the conference
right.
with San Mig Coffee.
Right.
And once the conference is done, then
right.
you can guest on the show.
Right.
That showed a lot of respect for Coach Tim and, of right. course, San Mig Coffee.
Right.
But now, obviously, you're the head coach of Barangay Ginebra.
Right.
Did it ever occur to you, did it ever dawn on you at some point in your career that you were going to end up coaching Ginebra?
You know, to be honest with you, not at all. It was, you know, came out of nowhere a little bit. But like I said, it's as an assistant coach, it's your career path. And you always want the opportunity to be given to you. So this chance came to me, and I'm grabbing it. And hopefully, you know, good things will happen.
There are certain expectations and a huge amount of pressure
right.
when you're coaching a team like Ginebra. Of course, it's got a huge fan base.
Right.
And when you have a history like Barangay Ginebra as well,
right.
there's a certain pride that comes with a team name.
Right.
And so, I mean, you already won your first game. Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you.
So far, what has your ride with Barangay Ginebra been like?
Well, it's been kind of wild, like emotionally. Just the mere fact that you're coaching Ginebra. Remember, I played 15 years against Ginebra.
Yeah.
And it wasn't hard to get pumped up and ready to play Ginebra because you got the fan base.
Mm-hmm.
You know, every game that I'm in Nunod, there's so many people screaming and yelling at you. And to be honest with you, as a player, my goal was, because we only had maybe 10% of the fans that game, my goal was to send 90% of everybody sad. So, you know, now that I'm coaching Ginebra and, you know, I understand the history, I understand mm-hmm. how much fan support they have. I think with you being a head coach in any team, there's always pressure. And with this, it's basically you just set your mind straight on just trying to improve the team. And that's all I'm trying to do. I'm trying to improve the team, improve the culture a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
And then hopefully good things will follow after that.
I'm glad you brought up your history playing against Ginebra
right.
because you actually faced Pedro Arencio
right.
in your very first game as a head coach.
Right.
And
right.
you guys have had your own,
right.
games against
right.
each other.
Right, right.
When you face someone like Pedro Arencio and you know him as a player and you got to see him as a coach in the past few years,
right.
how did you prepare for the game against Globalport?
Well, you know, I knew that going into the game that, first of all, Globalport is going to be tough, you know. They're going to be physical, you know. They're going to run. They're going to try to speed up the game a little bit. And basically, that's all the personality of Coach Pido. So as a head coach and you know, actually, Coach Tim was the one who told me this. You got to coach to your personality. And I expected that from Coach Pido. Going into that game, you know, it was going to be tough. And luckily, we just found a way to win.
Okay, speaking of Coach Tim, we just had him on the show last Monday.
Right.
And of course, we had to ask him about you. And you actually watched the show.
Right.
Your reactions to his comments about you.
Oh, I was really just humbled and very happy with Coach Tim. You got to understand, I've had a long relationship with Coach Tim. So not just as a player, but not just as an assistant coach lately, but really a friend, mentor. I could really talk to him about almost everything. Everything under the sun I talked to him about. So he knows me, you know, he knows me. And just to be able to be under his wings a little bit as a coach and just to play under him as a player, I think just, you know, such a blessing. If I may say, he gave me the opportunities for both. He gave me the opportunities to be a player in the PBA
mm-hmm.
because he drafted me.
Yeah.
He saw my potential and he stuck with me and he was tough with me and You know, we had a great relationship, and then even as an assistant coach, you know, I'm in the States, wanting to coach, but not at this level. And you know, after a year, he gives me a call, and I'm back in Manila under his wings, you know, coaching San Miguel Coffee.
When you play for a coach like Tim Cone, it's impossible that you don't learn anything. And when you are mentored by a coach like Tim Cone, especially as an assistant coach, right, and he specifically asked you,
right,
to become his assistant coach,
right,
what, I mean, obviously, aside from the triangle offense,
right,
what else do you take away with you?
Right. You know, everyone knows Coach Tim for his triangle offense and what he brings to, what he brought to Alaska and what he's bringing right now to San Miguel Coffee. There's a lot more to what you run in regards to offense. You know, there's a lot of things that he teaches you that most people don't, most coaches don't, you know. Number one is, you know, he'll show you how to play defense. He won't just tell you. Number two is he'll give you the freedom offensively to sort of find your way and be able to you know, let your game sort of, you know, blossom a little bit. But there's another side to it where people don't really know, where it's the personal side, it's the character side, it's the person. So, you know, he believes in high character guys. And when you have a group that's high character, you know, the team is high character. And it's easier to go through hard times. You know, when you go tough time, when you go through adversity, you know, you're able to stick together. You're able to do things together and really find a way to come out of it. You know, basketball, you know, you win some, you lose some. And as much as we celebrate the winning, I mean, we've had our share of losing. So it's really how you handle it. And that's one thing I think that I really learned from him, is just how to handle adversity.
Was it a bittersweet exit from San Miguel Coffee? You won your fourth championship as
Correct.
Assistant coach with Tim Cone.
Right.
And then you didn't exactly have that much time jumping from San Miguel Coffee to coaching Ginebra.
Right.
And you come out with a bam. I mean, you win another championship.
Right.
Was it bittersweet?
A little bit, because you know you're with the group for so long, almost 3 years, where you establish a culture that, you know, that's there already. So now it's just finding a way to win consistently, and so you go from there to sort of starting over again, and that's what I'm doing now. But like I said, it's a career path of an assistant coach. You know, this is where I want to be. You know, I'm happy that I'm the head coach of Ginebra. I think there's a lot I can bring to this team, and again, we just have to establish it slowly, because you know it's not going to happen overnight. You know, it didn't happen overnight for him, so it's mm-hmm. definitely going to happen overnight for me. So, yeah, it was kind of crazy for a while, because I was going back and forth. You know, because we were you know, running for another championship. So there were times during the finals where I'd go back and forth. But it's part of the job. It's part of the job.
You're familiar with that culture, though. You've experienced it. I mean, you have 13 championships in total, 9 as a player. You had 6 with Alaska, 2 with Coca-Cola, and 1 with Mobiline. And then, again, I just mentioned the 4 championships with Coach Tim Cone as his assistant coach.
Right.
You also won a championship in the UAAP in 2006 for USD. But, you know, when you think of all that, and you have the culture of winning, the culture of course, you played for Tim Cone, and you also played under Coach Chot.
Right.
And you have all these accolades backing you up. 1995 PBA Rookie of the Year, 10-time PBA All-Star, 4-time All-Defensive Team, 4-time Mythical First Team, 2002 PBA All-Filipino Best Player of the Conference, 2003 PBA All-Filipino Finals Most Valuable Player. That's a long list.
That just shows how old I am. That's how that is.
But when you have that kind of a resume backing you up, how do you think that affects everyone's perception of you coming into Ginebra as a head coach for the first time in your career?
I think it helps in regards to respect. You know, again, I'm going into Ginebra and I'm also learning. I'm also going in there, you know, understanding that they have to get used to me as much as I have to sort of get used to them and understand, you know, their personalities and how they do things and, you know, what they like, what they don't like, and what motivates them, what doesn't. So I think first and foremost, respect is very important at the beginning. And remember, I've played against more than half of these guys that I'm coaching now. So they knew me as a player. Yeah. So hopefully they see how hard I worked. They saw how I was really attentive to all the details, the little details, which is something that I'm really trying to bring in now. Just them really paying attention to the little things. So you pay attention to the little things, then the big picture will take care of itself.
All right, Coach Jeff answers some of your questions when we return. This is the Solar Sports Desk. Keep it here. It is time for Jeff Cariaso to answer some of your questions. And here we go. From Neth Lingat, do you think the guys you have on Ginebra right now can help the team end the six-year title drought?
Of course I do. Of course I do. Because if I don't believe it, how can I expect them to believe it? So, but like I said, you know, Rome wasn't built in a day. So we're taking it day, you know, one day at a time. And we're just trying to build and get better. You know, and hopefully from there, like I said, you know, good things will happen.
So far, so good. 1-0 right now. From Mon Baltimore, how did the veterans react to the new system of the triangle, especially JJ and Mark, whose careers shined in the run and gun play with their tenure with BGK?
You know, what's interesting is most people don't understand that they're still going to be able to run. Just because you run the triangle doesn't mean they're not going to be able to, you know, running good, like what they say. But they accepted it well. I'm really happy with my vets. So, you know, Mark, JJ, Billy, JR, LA, you know, they're really setting the examples for all the younger guys. And it helps. It helps, you know. If I can coach them, and they're on the court with their teammates, they're able to help out and coach them also. You know, that just means we're going to be able to understand everything sooner and quicker.
Okay, from Nate Alumno, when the time comes, this conference that Barangay Ginebra faces San McCoffee, what strategy will you use on your own, considering that Coach Tim has mastered the triangle?
Well, I can't say because he might be watching, right? So, no, you know, right now, to be honest with you, I'm not even thinking about that game. You know, that game on its own, it's going to be, you know, really hyped and you know, there'll be no need for motivation. So right now, I'm just focused on tomorrow. We play Morocco Bolts, a real tough Morocco Bolts team. And yeah, just trying to take care of them first.
Okay, I'm glad someone brought this. How did the vets, again, you've played against these guys as well. How did the vets take you in?
Open arms, really. I mean, I can't ask for anything more. You know, they're really eager to learn, you know, what I'm bringing in. You know, it really helps when you buy into it and you accept it, because they set the examples for the younger guys. The younger guys will look at the vets and see how they handle it, how they react. So, you know, like I said, you know, I'm happy with the way they've been accepting it and the way they've been working hard each and every day.
All right, we read replies to our Twitter topic of the night when we return. This is the Solar Sports Desk. Keep it here. Earlier, we asked you who you think will win Game 3 of the Eastern Conference Finals, the Miami Heat or the Indiana Pacers. And here are some of the replies we got via Twitter. From Jason XXX, Miami all the way. Paul George is not 100% even if he plays. From Marlon Morales, my heart says Pacers, but my mind says it's the Heat. From Kenneth Lagitan, Miami Heat, if Paul George will not play, it'll be hard for Indiana to have a decent scorer. Jeff.
Real good points. I'm going with Miami also. One is because I think being at home helps a lot. So they're going to Miami now, and playing in front of your home crowd is a big factor. And I think this is the time where they push and you know they need to dig deep, and I think they'll come out victorious.
With the NBA Finals, of course, in the Western Conference, you have the Oklahoma City Thunder and the San Antonio Spurs, who are just demolishing them every game.
Right.
And then over in the East, you have the Heat and the Pacers.
Right.
The Heat are being the Heat, as usual. And the Pacers, they've had a rocky season, to say the least. I mean, they still made it to the finals, but they're not as consistent.
Right. I think they struggle towards the end of the elimination round. So right now, during the playoffs, it's a roller coaster ride for them. Remember, they started off really strong. I mean, they have the best record in the East. So that's why they have home court advantage all throughout. But I think just being, just facing a experienced and, you know, proven champion team like Miami, they got to find that extra edge, that extra ump to be able to get past them. And right now they're struggling, but, you know, I believe this series will go 6 or 7. But like I said, game 3 will go to Miami.
All right. Well, unfortunately, we do have to wrap up. But before we go, please do invite the legions of Barangay Ginebra fans. I believe you have a game tomorrow.
Right. I just want to say, first of all, that to all the Ginebra fans out there, you know, we'll see you tomorrow. We play Morocco for our second game of the conference. Really, thank you all for all the kind words that I've been receiving on Twitter. You know, it's not going to be easy. You know, it's going to be tough all throughout, but it's supposed to be tough. So I'm excited with the team, and I know you are. And just pray and hope, you know, you just support us all throughout, through the ups and the downs. So thank you.
All right. Thank you, Jeff.
All right.
That is all the time we have for you guys tonight. Log on to our website, www.solarsportsdesk.ph. Follow us on Twitter and like us on Facebook. And download the Solar News app on your smartphones and tablets.